I have been watching my weight. Anyway, the camera adds pounds, you know that, right? Hello, I'm Lawrence and I'm on a quest to uncover all of the memos that Britain and America lost in the pond, and one of those memos pertains to pie. We're fast approaching that time of year again when everybody puts aside the salads in favour of pastries, cakes and circular crusts. In a normal year, this period would last about a month. In 2020, some of us got a 9-month head start. It's like the 2019 holidays didn't actually end. Either way, with Christmas, Thanksgiving, and my birthday on the horizon, my fridge is more stocked than a stocked up Christmas stocking from Stockholm. What you need to understand about me is I come from a country that loves pie, but we love it in a different way to America. That's to say that our shelves are lined with pork, mince, lamb shanks, Bramley apple, and steak and kidney pies. It's important that I mention apple pie because that one is widely synonymous with America. However, not only did I devour apple pie routinely in England, but the recipe originated there. Nonetheless, this didn't stop new and unfamiliar pies from entering my life, not to mention my fridge, after I moved to America. And I suppose it was only meant to be. So when I was 18, not a day went by when British friends didn't reference the 1999 film American Pie, usually in the context of how I resembled one of the actors. And so here are four actual pies I only ate after moving to America. Back when I lived in Britain, the mild climate wasn't conducive to growing sweet potatoes. As it turns out, we had them partly imported from North and South Carolina. But they never seemed to carry the same culinary currency as they do in the US. Here, they're not only widely available in the form of fries or cooked potatoes, but also pies. The sweet potato pie originated in the southern US in the 17th century after sweet potatoes became a big part of southern and African American cuisine. After relocating to Indiana in November 2008, not 4 days had passed before I was offered my first taste of this mysterious concoction. My initial inclination was that I would absolutely hate sweet potato because, thanks to carrots and pumpkin, I didn't trust the colour orange. But, and I hope this wins back the trust of the American people, and Rachel Ray, I actually love sweet potato to the extent that I now prefer sweet potato fries to regular fries. But with the pie, it's a slightly different story. Sadly, unlike most people, my mouth was built with taste receptor cells that fervently believe cinnamon is the devil. Since this is often an ingredient of sweet potato pie, you won't catch me eating it every day. But if cinnamon-flavored orange desserts are your thing, this pie is a must. No. American pie isn't a specific type of pie. It's, you know, have you seen the film? Right. Well, then this is pretty awkward. Here's an idea. Google it. All right. I really do have to go. It's been great catching up with your grandma. Say hi to Doris. I know. Here goes Lawrence again, about to lambast this universally loved food item, but I'm not going to do that here today, because I already did it a year ago.
I will say that it was at least somewhat edible. There was no need for the whipped cream, if I'm honest, but I'd give this, I think, maybe a 2.5 out of 5. That's 50%.
And to this day, I stand by the comparisons between sweet potato pie and pumpkin pie.
It tastes the same.
You are going to get so many negative comments from that.
It tastes the same.
So many. You're going to get so much hate.
It tastes the same.
Yeah. No, it's awful. You're right. Grandma, I really do have to go. I wasn't kidding. No, I'm not going to eat all the pies. I have been watching my weight. Anyway, the camera adds pounds, you know that, right? It hasn't added 25 pounds. What do you think I've been doing? But my verdict on pumpkin pie doesn't take away from the fact that it is a supremely popular dessert during Thanksgiving. In fact, this has been the case for the past 200 years, or 400 years if you add in 2020. Actually, a pumpkin pie of sorts was eaten by early English colonists in the New World. However, this more likely came in the form of soup. The pilgrims would have made it themselves because Panera bread hadn't reached Massachusetts yet. This Thanksgiving, just like last, my wife will be eating pumpkin pie, but for me, there's only one pie that really matters, and it's this. Here's a true story. 5 years ago, I began a one-sided love affair with pecan pie. Until Thanksgiving of 2015, I'd largely overlooked it, and there were a couple of reasons for this. Firstly, pecan pie was, and probably still is, culturally less significant in the UK. But even after moving to America, I wasn't sold on nut-based sweets. The truth is, for me, any dessert worth its sugar had to be loaded with chocolate. But in 2015, I did something reckless. I abstained from chocolate for a whole year. Now this freed me up to try new foods like pistachio ice cream, strawberry cheesecake, and vegetables. And that Thanksgiving at my in-laws' get-together, I finally did it. I ate pecan pie. It's hard to put into words what a profound moment this was. It was like my taste buds had finally woken up from a chocolate-induced nightmare, perhaps something resembling the boat ride in Willy Wonka.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but the thing is, America has way more pies than that, right? These are just the ones that I've personally had. Well, for instance, I haven't had peach pie or sugar pie or blueberry pie or cream pie. Cream pie. No, don't Google that one. The true origins of pecan pie are disputed. Some believe that French settlers invented it in New Orleans. Others think it got its start in Alabama. Either way, it's most certainly another pie of southern origin, much like this. When you move to another country, you sometimes encounter things you feel you should have encountered before, but haven't. For me, this was key limes. While regular limes are readily available in the UK, the more aromatic key limes are nowhere to be found. And this could be something to do with the fact that they're most commonly found in the Americas, where they're also known as West Indian or Mexican limes. But the American use of key sadly has nothing to do with the fruit's ability to unlock portals to mystical worlds like Oz, Narnia, or Michigan. It's because the fruit was naturalized in Florida's Key West. And out of it came yet another southern creation, key lime pie. Apparently this dessert has been a staple of the American holidays since about the 1930s, and with good reason. Made with key lime juice, egg yolks, and sweetened condensed milk, even I was sold on it. Sure, thanks to my unrelenting addiction to pecan pie, I've only had it once, but it was amazing. And it's not just me that thinks so. Ask contestants of Florida's Mile High Key Lime Pie Eating Contest, which contributes 4% to all Florida Man stories. Probably. Overall, a great holiday pie which the cinnamon doesn't overwhelm.
This is goodbye for real. I really have to go.
What? Yes, I did. It arrived on Friday. Thank you for that. One thing, it says happy 59th inside. I'm in my 30s. What's wrong with the haircut? Hello?